Welcome back. Last time we got the smoke drop online, which should be a good anti-tumblebug, anti-moth, not really anti-blobber, but it should also be useful against the alpha diggers that will no doubt be showing up on the final mission. That's kind of the other reason I like to pick up a weapon like that, is sometimes damage and displacement just aren't enough. But, hey, we've got them in the meantime. Okay, we're doing a kill five or fewer enemies mission, whether we like it or not. And, you know, that's exactly the opposite of what Kai wants to do. Kai wants to kill everything in the universe forever. Okay, well, we'll have to manage. I mean, otherwise we're doing ice mines. We'll put a pin in that for later, but I don't think that's really where we want to go. I want to go this way. Alright, we are going to need to do an aggressive program of killing the problem enemies like the Alpha Tumblebugs immediately. Probably letting the bouncers live. Yeah, kill you, you, and then you. And then start spawn blocking. That is simply what you have to do to get anywhere. Alright. I think that's about it. Not really a lot of good safe places for a blob to go, but you'd probably deploy a tank and get rid of the blob by bumping it into one of our own mechs. That's probably how this is going to play out. Well, we'll see. This is actually a good pairing. This actually thematically makes a certain amount of sense. Like, now we actually can use the ice to our benefit, and I guess we're just gonna use an ice weapon whether we like it or not. Like, that's just plain old gonna happen. Alright, so, first order of business. I need to free you, I think, so that you can go over there and kill you. Who else could possibly do something similar? Nobody, really? And there's the blob. So, need to deal with this, need to deal with this, need to deal with this. We've got three actions. So, for starters, you could just use your smoke drop on the first turn. Like, that'll handle that. It won't kill you, but that's potentially not even a problem. You were probably the one I wanted to leave alive anyway. Yeah, okay. Seems a little bit wasteful to be dropping this early, but if it works, it works. And we'll certainly block that spawn. And deploy the tank. Yeah, okay. That's all there was to it. It looked a little bit complicated, but really nothing going on here. I don't think I'm going to hydraulic legs jump on this. I probably want to injure you just in case that's the solution to a turn. Yeah, like, next turn is going to be so quiet, there's going to be barely anything to do, so you'll have time to repair. Okay, and that gets that out of the way. There's not much to worry about here. I'm overthinking this. So, now we've got a wall of frozen enemies and a wall of smoke. That is actually kind of annoying. I kind of thought you were going to go down here or something, but, no, you started up here, right? Right, so you couldn't even reach down here, so that's why you had to go up there. Okay. Well, that's fine. Kai can reach you anyway. Keep up the good work. Keep blocking. We actually can't, we can. I was gonna say we can't stand on this tile if the Alpha Bouncer is attacking that tile, so simply don't let the Alpha Bouncer attack that tile. There we go. Sure. And, yeah, the ice storms are doing our work for us. Eventually we'll want to get this rock out of the way, but there's no hurry. Alright. Seems fine. We are doing the thing you're supposed to do on this mission. You can jump pretty far. Not far enough to get on the spawn, but far enough, I guess. Like, jump, like, here or something. Sure, this is reasonable. Now we kill you. I mean, I could just push you over. I should have done this in the other way around. I think I really did actually just want to repair and do that before that rock ended up there. Alright, do this first. That's fine, it should not go there because you've got two attacks to do from here. Now you do this. And you just sit tight here. And, sure, bring you up. Alright, well, you wanted me to kill barely any enemies. I'm doing it. Yeah, last turn. Alright. Fine. If that's the way it has to be, then that's the way it has to be. The tank is gonna get frozen. Alright, that's fine. We didn't even really participate that much in this battle. We smoked this area, and we just kind of let the ice storm do whatever it wanted. We weren't exactly bystanders, but we weren't exactly involved either. Sometimes some forces are just greater than us. Nature was, like, the industrial processes here were just at another scale entirely, messing with nature. This'll be more technical, but the light tank might be the perfect thing to counter that. If we can get some bumps set up, that should counter the shield advantage. And then we just go to town and pummel everything. Or we could just do this. This is like the same thing, but not as technical. Four enemies, and we could just kill stuff. We might do that later, but for now, I'll give this a try. Sure. Maybe I should have thought twice about taking on shielded tumblebugs. Maybe I shouldn't have been that cavalier about the whole thing. Well, at least we have a scorpion that can't do anything, so we'll see. But, alright. I mean, I'm glad that there aren't any moths on the field. I'm glad that things aren't as miserable as I expected them to be. Oh. Huh. Well, I didn't actually know that. The rocks get shielded, too. Huh. Fancy that. Anyway, the tumblebugs have still gotta go. I mean, that's non-negotiable. So, I guess we just let this happen and let that happen. Maybe this isn't a turn where we destroy the shield generator. Kill the tumblebugs first, then worry about that. Hmm. You can't actually get right here. Okay, so maybe we kill you then. We leave this alone. We just kind of body block in this tumblebug. Hmm. I don't really like putting you down here, but I guess it's alright. Hang on. Is this a... I think this is a friendly unit, so I think that means a tank could move through it. So if I moved you, say, all the way up here, you could throw the tank here, and I think that means the tank would be able to move through that, and then do this and bump that, and I think that would be alright. So then you just have to move out of the way. Hmm. Both of you want to use this tile. Alright, fine. This is more important to get done. And then I guess that just means you're firing the tank from down here. And much as I don't like you being all the way over here, it's still alright, I think. Okay, this'll do. We're gonna have 5 enemies next turn, but we still have the shields up, and our position is improved. And you're surrounded, but you can jump if you really need to. And meanwhile, everybody's being a great distraction. Sure. Yeah. Yeah, no problem. That will make you hit the rock. But if I throw this rock away, then it's fine, actually. It's a good thing. Okay, that looks pretty good. And next turn, we destroy the shield generator. Right, you haven't even done anything yet. Yeah, go kill you. Yeah, there we go. Alright, and that's one fewer thing to worry about, and we should be able to just... Yeah, we've got rounded... Wow. Language. Destroy the shield generator, destroy the enemies. No problem. You can't actually do that, because can't throw that. So I think we're going to have to settle for just, like, bumping you into that. Or I guess you can do it. Yeah, you can do it. That's fine. Where do you even go? I guess you could block a spawn. Yeah. One fewer enemy to deal with on the last turn. Now you can do this. Sure. Alright, there. No problem. We probably might even be able to use you to repair next turn. And we still have the smoke drop in reserve, so no matter what this enemy does, we're fine. Alright, it's a 5 HP bouncer. That is not going to save it. Okay, Henry. Don't cause a forest fire for no reason. Thank you. I think Zenith wants these forests not on fire. Okay, I was a little worried about that, but, hey, it worked. I'm a little worried about what that implies, like, just being able to eat a power drain of an order of magnitude larger than it's supposed to be, with no problems in the short term, at least. I guess there's a lot of slack in the power grid or something. Right, okay. I don't think I need any special considerations for this, I think we can just go. Yeah, I think we're fine. Right, what did... No, you didn't level up yet. Well, we'll get that here. That won't be a problem. 5 enemies? Eh. Well, it could be a problem, but we can intercept the Alpha Tumblebugs, so that should defang you. The Moths are gonna mess everything up, but that's okay. That's alright. It's in their job description. That's just what they're gonna do. Sure. So the Tumblebug is harmless. The Scorpion is much less harmless, but we might be able to ignore it. And the Cannon Bot, we might be able to tank. Maybe. In fact, it's guaranteed to be firing down this line. Do I want you to be webbed? Maybe I don't. But if I don't place somebody here, then the Scorpion could make it to that building. So, yeah, honestly, I think we're in a better... Yeah, like, everybody can survive a Scorpion hit, so I think we just want the Scorpion to web us, and then, plan on... you can jump out of the way. I don't know what exactly is going to happen. You might end up, smoke dropping if you're webbed. You might end up deploying the tank if you're webbed. And if you're webbed, then you also mostly don't care. You don't really have anything particularly fancy to do if you're webbed, but we'll manage. Everybody's where they need to be. It's fine. I'm a little worried about what that might mean for the pod. If an explosion might happen. That's fine. This is a fine thing to be happening. This is okay. Kill the mods. Alright, can do. I'd like somebody to be in the way of that. You do fire first, so I think... Yeah, can I get a moth to be here? Only if I, judo throw it, which would involve actually somebody else getting rid of you. But that could happen. I could deploy the tank and shoot you out of the way. That would be alright. Something like, do this. Or do I want to just throw you for three? Instead of getting the tank out. I think I want to get the tank out. Which means you want to be... Where? I guess here is okay. I can't really deploy the tank to where I'd like to go, which is right here. But I do want to pick up that pod, just to make sure it's not in the blast radius of any of these rocks. So let's get the pod, and then do the thing I was gonna do. Okay, that should pretty well take care of the other moth. It's gonna back up and bump. We're gonna take 2 damage from this, but that's alright. The cannon bot's safe. We're doing a good job walling off the Tumblebug from getting back here. If it puts a rock here, I think I can deal with it. So I think we're good. The Scorpion might end up here, but, we'll kill somebody with you. We'll manage. But yeah, this is all working out the way it's supposed to be. The moths are dead. That's what really matters. Okay, well, you're gonna be in the way, but you'll burn to death. Okay. I think the easiest way to deal with you is to damage the hacking facility. Can I do that? Only if I attack it twice. So there's you I've gotta deal with. This is... technically a problem, but you trade, so it's not that bad. I've also got smoke drop. I could smoke drop you. If I'm not ready to destroy this yet. And I think I'm not. I think I want I just want both Tumblebugs dead, probably. Right. So I can't have you both kill a Tumblebug and somebody else do the smoke drop. So let's see. One attack. And that's it. Yeah, you're dead. So I just have one action to deal with you. Two actions to deal with you, and then you take care of yourself, and that's actually alright. Which means that since you can't be involved with destroying this, you and you destroy this, and you have to run up here and kill the, well, not kill, but, handle the Alpha Tumblebug. Which is acceptable. So that would look something like... where do I want you to be? I guess you'll just do this now. Right, so you do this. You do this, which is drastic overkill, but worth it. Now... you wouldn't have been able to go to this tile anyway. This is in the way. Okay, I was just trying to check if there was some way I could kill this outright, but I think the answer to that is no. So yeah, you do this. You do this, and you go up here and do this. There we go. Unfortunately, this means that the Tumblebug gets to live, so we're going to get two rocks next turn, but at least you're not going to be causing any real problems. And we have five units out on the field, so I think we should be able to manage. What have we got? Minor problem, much less... Oh, that's a little more hairy. If I can kill you and... Well, move you and kill you, then that's probably the way to go. You just need to kind of be gently moved out of the way. This would be a problem if all we had was pushing weapons, but I came prepared. Yeah, we'll do this. You can hop over this, thankfully. You're gonna get hit by that rock, but that, you know what, that's fine. That is acceptable. Unless we kill you, which we still can. Yeah, hold on. Okay. That'll do. That'll do nicely. Alright, you can participate too. Make sure that's dead. Very, very dead. Alright. No problem. At least so I think. So says I. Right, okay. We'll just give him the old 1-2 here. Throw right into a suplex. You start working on bomb disposal. And you start working on other bomb disposal. Alright. Job well done, everyone. Welcome to the team, Cannonbot. Oh, I'm sorry, you have to stay behind? That's alright. I believe in you, Cannonbot. You can help protect the home front. Surprisingly good with the Herald's ability. Too bad it waited this long to show up. Don't really need it right now. Yeah, we can definitely do this. No problem. This is just a great combo. High threat detected and break buildings out of the ice. That really makes up for it. So, one more core. Where to? We might eventually want to get this, maybe, but at the same time, how much do we need it? Maybe we just, get started working on you? Yeah, you could use this for 4 turns. Alright. Alright, perfect. You love to see it. Just everybody just stuck back here. Yeah, we might even... Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves, but we might need to attack the cities ourselves to break the ice. We'll see. We'll see how thoroughly we dominate this one. Yeah, I do not need to sweat this one. It's fine. We'll figure it out. We've got the tools to succeed. Alright, for once, the moths are not actually the priority targets anymore. Now I just want to kill the Tumblebugs and just get them out of the way right now while things are safe. Am I willing to let Kai take a hit so that that can happen, though? Maybe not. Maybe I kill this another way? Well, I'll definitely get the tank out. That's clearly happening. The tank can actually survive 2 damage, so that's nice. Or I can deploy it here and then move it out of the way. That's even better. Alright, not a problem for now. This is good. I think I've lost track of who is doing what. Are you on ice? Yes, you are on ice. So if I do damage to your tile to crack it, then the boulder would blow it up. Alright, I think I've got it. Nobody actually moved that, so I didn't want to bump this egg into this building. But besides that, everything was good. This is a good setup. So we'll simply reset turn, not do that, do something else with this, and call it good. Maybe I'll, like, shove this scorpion even farther backwards or something. So let's see. What order did I do all that in again? It's like, I think we can do this first. Yeah, this all made sense. So you first... Then you. Then deploy the tank onto this tile, move it, and then just shove the scorpion backwards. And then where do you want to stand? I don't know. I guess just here. It's fine. Okay. That looks good. I mean, you're in water, but we can rescue you if we have to. Glorious. You love to see it. Not an issue. Tumblebug all the way back there is actually not a problem. Like, that's the nice thing about them. They only have 3 movement. And sometimes you could just wall them off just as well as you would a scorpion. Like, that Tumblebug is not gonna be a problem for the rest of the mission. So, now we actually just do need to get started on, killing stuff. Well, both killing stuff and, destroying, ice. But that's fine. We've got time for that. Here. You start getting to work on this. That's fine. Let's just say that that's why I upgraded the tank's health. Sure, just in case I wanted to do that. So now we should be able to ignore most of these enemies and start getting to work on destroying the ice. Maybe you'll help me out. Put a blob right there. No, okay, that's fine too. The enemies are not doing anything. I think I'm gonna have to do their job for them. I want to do damage to this tile. I want to just wall them off entirely. Who can really do that? I guess you. Sure. But before I do that... Here, you can help out. That will kill the Herald. Okay, I already used my reset, so... Oh, you can't even repair now. Oops. That's fine. Instead, you're gonna go up here. That's alright. Look, it's fine. It's fine. No problem. Need one more. You should still do this, I think. And then you should go here. Alright, that's more like it. This isn't even a damn mission. This is just a river I am unfreezing. Okay, destroy one more of these. Sure, you can do it. You're taking care of yourself. You can't jump anymore, unfortunately, so you're just gonna have to settle for just, doing some light tapping. That's alright. And you sneak through here and chuck you here. Alright. Good enough. So, that's exactly what I was talking about. We didn't get swarmed with moths, just a whole bunch of ground enemies, so... had to do all the work myself. And that's gotta really be saying something about how well this is going. Who are we up against? The Goose. Alright. Now it's time to get out the big guns. You'll definitely help out with killing things, like having as many attacks on the field as possible. This would be funny, but no. Maybe we'll play a game with that sometime. Maybe I'll do a custom squad where that's one of the weapons we start with. Do a little bit of the old console editing to play around with that. Design a squad where that's the idea. It could happen. I probably want to give this the chance to attack my mechs if possible. So, let's at least deploy in such a way that might happen. And then, you are hopeless. You are not even... Like, if I didn't have a mech here, you wouldn't be able to do anything. All things being equal, I probably want to give you the chance to attack. Although, maybe I don't. Like, if I'm not here, where will you go? I think you're just going to kind of wander around over here-ish. Maybe you'll go up here. I don't know what you're... I don't have a super good insight into what enemies do when they don't when they aren't able to attack anything, I just know that they tend to prefer to move forwards towards the center. But I don't know what that involves. So I don't know exactly where he's going to move, but I think he's going to prefer to go here than here. I think. So if that's the case, I guess I might as well encourage him to attack this way so he knocks himself backwards for next turn. Fewer places he can go. Sure. I think we'll be alright here. This should work. You're a little bit out of the way, but you're doing your job. Okay, that's fine. Worth a try. Okay, we do need to destroy the Scion, though. We cannot have 3 HP or 2 HP minions lying around. So, you do need to die at some point. I think this is the way. Yeah, that clearly needs to die. Alright, that looks pretty good. I think you're even gonna block a spawn. Yeah, this is perfect. Well worth taking the damage for. Yeah. Alright, so the Tumblebugs are coming in late, but this is a wide open map. We have control of the situation. I think things should be pretty good as long as we don't let the goos get out of control, so I think that means we don't actually want to kill them super fast. So you're definitely doing that. I think we're going to kill this one. Well, no, it's actually time to deploy the tank. That's right. That's the answer. There we go. Now we can have our cake and eat it too. Block a spawn and get started with this. And we're not going to kill this yet. Right? Yeah, I think we just leave that alone. 5 is enough. We kill this next turn. Alright, what have we got? Okay, good. That's a Tumblebug that's getting walled out. Very good. You love to see it. Alright, this is more our speed. Yeah, you are gonna have to... Are you gonna have to light yourself on fire? So let's see. That is an attacking grid. You're attacking grid. That's it. Nobody else is attacking grid. So I think we kill these first. Then we kill you on, like, the final turn or something. So you might not actually need to jump. Who's going first? You are. So if I do nothing, you go here and the moth kills you. How much move do you have? 5? Okay, I think here's how we're gonna do this. I think we're just gonna take things easy. We're not gonna just jump right into fire. We don't have to. We're not in that much of a rush, thankfully. You can just stay there. Honestly. You're doing fine. And you know what? Yeah, suffer not a moth to live. And we'll just chuck you back here. And we should be in good shape. All we've got to do is kill this. The little goose won't even have a chance to attack, and we have one Tumblebug. So situations like this are why the developers invented unfair mode. They definitely succeeded. They definitely made an unfair mode. You've got to give them that. Alright, stomp that goo into the dust. Get you out of there. And, call it good. We're all done here. That's fine. I'll just let Zenith decide what to do with those. No problem. No problem at all. Even less of a problem than I thought it would be. I don't think we really need any of this stuff. No? No, that's fine. We're just gonna walk out into the sunset. I know that's not what luchadors do, but that's what we're doing. We're gonna go shopping and call it good. I mean, oh, right. We do have to actually take one of these. Okay. Show us the store. Nah. These are fun to play around with, but honestly, I think we're fine. This is a pretty good loadout, and I'm happy. The sense of security the smoke drop gives me is quite nice. No, we can have the spider-themed luchador party some other time. So long, rail cannon. I was thinking I might have to rely on that, but not this time. Alright, I think that will do nicely. We could just not have to even worry about, self-damage. Yeah, 4 power cores. This is probably a good idea. It is tactically useful. It is awful tempting to just power this all the way up to 3 damage. And I'm not really seeing anything better to do. I mean, more movement on you wouldn't hurt either. You are melee range. Yeah, this actually really could matter. Okay, I'm gonna do that instead of the other one. Unless... maybe you don't worry about the health, and now we have 3, and now we can do this. Sure. Yeah. What kind of luchador would we be if we didn't power up the hydraulic legs to maximum strength? If we're going to stomp the floor, it better make shockwaves that explode. It's only right.